Hello everyone, I'm Divarani Pandurang Babar, working as an assistant professor at AISSMS IOIT Pune. Let's discuss part 3 of set identities. We will continue our discussion on set identities in this particular presentation. So here we are going to study De Morgan's laws. Now, first De Morgan's law is A union B intersection is equal to A complement intersection B complement. And second De Morgan's law is A intersection B complement is equal to A complement union B complement. Now, first we will discuss first De Morgan's law. A union B complement. Now, A union B complement is nothing but the values of all x is such that x does not belongs to A union B. Now, here we can write x does not belongs to A union B as negation of x belongs to A union B. Now, we can write this x belongs to A or x belongs to B. So, by using first De Morgan's law, all values of x such that x does not belongs to A and x does not belongs to B. We can write this statement as x such that x belongs to A complement and x belongs to B complement. According to this statement, we can write x belongs to A complement intersection B complement. Thus, A union B complement is equal to A complement intersection B complement. Now, see the second De Morgan's law. A intersection B complement is equal to x such that x does not belongs to A intersection B. So we can write x does not belongs to A intersection B as negation of x belongs to A intersection B. So we can write x belongs to A and x belongs to B. Now by using second De Morgan's law, we can write x does not belongs to A or x does not belongs to B. Now here we can write this statement as x belongs to A complement or x belongs to B complement. So here x is such that x belongs to A complement union B complement. So A intersection B complement is equal to A complement union B complement. This is the De Morgan's laws. Now, next one is what? Absorption laws. First absorption law is A union A intersection B is equal to A. Second law is A intersection A union B is equal to A. Now, see the first absorption law, that is A union A intersection B. Now, here we have to prove that A union A intersection B is a subset of A and A is a subset of A union A intersection B. Now, let's consider first one, that is A union A intersection B is a subset of A. We know that x belongs to A or x belongs to A intersection B by the definition of A union B. Afterwards, let x belongs to A union A intersection B is equal to x belongs to A or x belongs to A and x belongs to B. Now, by first absorption law of logical equivalence, that is P or P and Q is equal to P. That means here we can write X belongs to A and X belongs to B as X belongs to A. So that here A union A intersection B is a subset of A. Now consider the second one, that is A is a subset of A union A intersection B. Now we know that an element of A union A intersection B is an element that is in A or A intersection B. Therefore, we can write X belongs to A union A intersection B. Okay, according to this, we can say A is a subset of A union A intersection B. So that A is equal to A union A intersection B. Okay, just we have to prove that left hand side is equal to right hand side. Consider the left hand side first, that is A intersection A union B. Now we know that what is A intersection B? A intersection B is nothing but the set of all values of X such that X belongs to A and X belongs to A union B. Now see here, we can write X belongs to A union B as X belongs to A or X belongs to B. Now from the second absorption law of logical equivalence, that is P and P or Q is equal to P. So we can write this statement as X such that X belongs to A, according to the logical equivalence. So we can say that left hand side is equal to right hand side. That means A intersection A union B is equal to A. Now next law is complement laws. A union A complement is equal to universal set, and A intersection A complement is equal to phi, that is null set. Now see the first law, that is left hand side is what? A union A complement. Now we know that what is the definition for A union B. So here we can write X such that X belongs to A or X belongs to A complement. And we know that X belongs to A or X belongs to A complement is nothing but the universal set. So here left hand side is equal to right hand side. That means A union A complement is equal to universal set. Now see the second law. Left hand side is what? A intersection A complement. So according to the A intersection B, we can write X is such that X belongs to A and X belongs to A complement. And we know that X belongs to A and X belongs to A complement is nothing but phi, that is null set or empty set. So left hand side is equal to right hand side. That means A intersection A complement is equal to phi, that is null set. This is all about the set identities. Thank you.